Hi everyone, welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be doing another second order differential equations problem. And the function that we're given is 4y double prime minus 4y prime minus 3y equals 0. Remember that y is supposed to represent like the original function, y prime is the first derivative, and y double prime is the second derivative. So with second order differential equations problems, we always use the formula y of x equals c sub 1 e to the r sub 1 times x plus c sub 2 e to the r sub 2 times x. And this is a basic problem. We're going to end up leaving c sub 1 and c sub 2 alone, so they'll appear in our final answer. All we're looking to solve for is r sub 1 and r sub 2. So we will find values for r sub 1 and r sub 2, plug them into the formula, and leave everything else as is, and that will be our final answer. So the way that we go about doing that is first by converting our original function here to the following. 4r squared minus 4r minus 3 equals 0. And basically what we're doing is you're plugging in 1 for y, the original equation, r for y prime, the derivative, and r squared for y double prime, the second derivative. If you have trouble remembering that, you can think of each of these hash marks here that represent, you know, the derivative and the second derivative as an exponent. So here, it's just a stupid trick, but we don't have any hash marks here on this y, so you can think of it as y to the 0. There are 0 hash marks. Anything raised to the 0 power is 1, so you're going to replace y with 1. Here you have 1 hash mark, so call it y to the 1. You're going to replace it with r to the 1. Here you have 2 hash marks. You can call it y squared. You're going to replace it with r squared. So it's just a basic trick, but that's how we convert from this equation to one with r's in it. So once we do that, we will go ahead and solve for r. In this case, we can factor. If you couldn't factor, you could use, you could complete the square, you could use the quadratic equation. In this case, we can factor. And our factors are 2r plus 1 and 2r minus 3. So when we break that into two separate equations, we'll set each one equal to 0 and solve for r. So we end up with 2r plus 1 equals 0. If we subtract 1 from both sides, we end up with 2r equals negative 1. And then dividing both sides by 2 gives us r equals negative 1 half. Now we're going to take 2r minus 3 and set that equal to 0. We will add 3 to both sides, and we'll get 2r equals 3. And then dividing both sides by 2 again gives us r equals 3 halves. So these are, putting them together, are two solutions for r. R is equal to negative 1 half. It is also equal to 3 halves. And you're always going to come up with two solutions because whether we factor, use the quadratic formula, complete the square, but however we solve for r, we'll end up here with two factors. So these are what we're going to plug in for r sub 1 and r sub 2. It doesn't particularly matter which order you plug them in. I plug the lesser number, the lower number, in for r sub 1 and the higher number in for r sub 2. So in my case, negative 1 half is going to go in for r sub 1, 3 halves is going to go in for r sub 2. And when we do that, you can see here negative 1 half in for r sub 1 and 3 halves in for r sub 2. Everything else in the formula stays the same. We leave c sub 1 and c sub 2 in there, as well as the variable x. So that's it. That's our final answer for this kind of second order differential equations problem. I hope that helped you guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!